In 1992, I did my master's thesis on a tool that would take a program and visualize this in various graphical forms. It would produce correctly formatted text, flowcharts, or Nasse-Schneidemann diagrams, and you'd even be able to edit these in an editor. Later, I went on pursuing my PhD, which I completed in 1997 on a topic named Configuration Management with Feature Logic. The idea was to use description logic to model changes in variants and to detect inconsistencies. This was pretty cool, but the problem was that apparently no developer was willing to learn description logics. Plus, configuration management was essentially solved, so I was disappointed. That's when a student of mine, Dorothea Lütkehaus, came along, and we developed the idea to use my old library for visualizing programs to visualize data structures rather than programs. Finally, I would be doing something useful. The resulting tool became a debugger named DDD, for Data Display Debugger. This is what DDD looked like. It had a command line interface, so you could enter arbitrary commands. You would also see the source code. You would be able to set breakpoints and see the current execution position. The interesting thing, however, about DDD, as the name says, Data Display Debugger, was the ability to show data structures. For instance, up here, we have visualized that pointer, list. And now I can double-click on the pointer to see where it points to. This is the element the pointer points to. I can check out what self points to. Obviously, it points to itself. I can look up the next value. Again, look up self. And again, look up the next value. And see that the whole thing becomes actually a linked list. Needless to say, as I keep on stepping through the program and as the values change, the display would be updated automatically just as well. DDD eventually became free software and was even adopted by the GNU project. So it became GNU DDD. And it became very popular with C and C++ programmers. Today, there's even Python support built into DDD. But I'm not maintaining this anymore, so I don't know how well this works.